Let's sit nice and tall. Then nice, nice arch in the low back, the nice arch, no slumping, lift, inner belly lift, lift through the crown of the head. And then become aware of your breath. Shoulders relaxed. Maybe let's try this small exercise, breathing exercise, just to become more aware of your breath. So you're gonna inhale through the nose. And then exhale, nice and long exhale through the mouth. So you're gonna feel it on your hand, okay? So through sort of pursed lips. So make it as long as possible. Exhale. And again, inhaling through the nose. And then exhale, feel the air and then on the hand, on the hand. Just blowing on your hand, basically, just to feel that air a few more times. Nice and long exhale. Until the belly sort of flattens almost, all the air is expelled, and then relax the belly. So you're gonna have to do like a gentle blow, right? If you blow too much, you run out of that air to nice gentle blow, so you can elongate that out breath. So what are you doing with these exercises? You know, it's not just like woo-woo. You're actually working the diaphragm, right? The breathing muscle that can get also sort of stuck in Parkinson's. You know, it can be affected by Parkinson's. Practicing deep breathing works the diaphragm, improves your lung capacity, and there's even some studies about deep belly breathing, how it affects the spinal fluid, and you know, it basically leads to more oscillation of the fluid and maybe better cleaning in the brain. So it's all very, very important. Not just something to wave away. So yeah, let's do some shoulder circles. Plus, it's really a connection to your nervous system. So you can, if you feel anxious, you can immediately use the breath to calm the nervous system. Good, and then we'll do that three-part inhale. So again, work in the diaphragm, the lung capacity. You're gonna go inhale, inhale. Inhale, so three parts of the inhale and then nice exhale through the nose. So everything goes through the nose now. Inhale, 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 and then nice smooth long exhale. And inhale. Fill your lungs and then slowly exhale all the way. Okay, let's do one more. Okay. Maybe let's do actually one or a couple more, and then on the exhale, let's do like a nice ah sound. Okay, nice and loud. So inhale, inhale, inhale. Open that mouth nice and wide, and then again, inhale, inhale, inhale. Ah. Good, last one. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Great. Yeah, so sounding is another way how to really work with your diaphragm and lung capacity. All right, and then let's do a nice big power up. So arms to the side, and then we'll go side to side, bending your sides. Good, and then stay here, and then maybe on your left side. And then we're gonna just move the head to look up and down, and up and down, if that's okay for your neck. Up and down. Look up, look down. Look up, look down. Good, and then come back to center, and we'll do the other side. So hold that side bend on the right, and then inhale, look up. Exhale, look down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. One more up. And down. Great. And then back to center. And then we'll interlace the fingers behind the head. And push the head back slightly against the hands, open the elbows. And if you can add a little bit of a back bend too. So lift your heart, arch your upper back, press the head back, and at the same time, you're supporting the head with the hands. So feel that opening in the armpits and the chest. Breathe. And then release. And let's do a little bit of rounding and arching. So that cat and cow, just gently focus on the rhythmic motion. So inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Good. And then inhaling, arms up, and then squeeze your knee in, left knee in, do some ankle circles. And reverse, give the other direction, nice big circle. And make it as smooth as possible, that movement. Good. And then switch sides. Underneath. Nice big smooth circles. And reverse. Perfect. Great. And then let's do a few stand-ups and sit downs as always. Nice and under control. Slow descend. Right. Perfect. All right. Right. Yeah, put the chair to the side. Yeah, you're gonna start with some calf lifts while I set up the music. So lifting the heels up and down. Okay, lots of tunes today. Okay. 5. March. Nice high knee. Hop on the arm and leg, go together. And then we're gonna go up and side. You can hold on if you want. Up, 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 high. Okay. One more on this side, and another side. Step up. Okay. Step up. Hey, couple more. Nice, good. And then let's tap to the side. So not a full step. Push. Push with a palm. Good, nice tap with the toes. Not a full step. You're not push. You're not shifting the weight, right? The weight stays here. So you could even do a little, kind of like this. So not touching, right? Let's try that. Not touching. And that leg there. Good. Nice, good. And then let's go in and out. Out, in, out, out. Out, out, in. Out, out. So right, left leg, right leg, and back in. Left, right, left. Right, left, right. Good, nice. And then we'll do the up of the knee touch. Cuando estás bien, te alejas de mí. Te sientes solo y siempre estoy ahí. Es una guerra de toma y dame. Breathing, nice tall posture. Oye, baby, no seas mala. No me dejes con las ganas. Se escucha en la calle que ya no me quieres. Ven y dímelo en la cara. Pregúntale a quien tú quieras. Mira, te juro que eso no es así. Yo nunca tuve una mala intención. Excellent, good. Amigo, ves. Back to march. And then let's do the full lick. So you're spreading the fingers open and make it fit. Then let's try crossing. You can flick it open. Like out. Up. You can alternate whichever arm is on top. I try to keep those arms straight as you cross. So it's not like this, right? But like this. Good. Right in those elbows. Good. And then let's just do the nice big arm swing. And let's do it just without the arm, the march. You can focus on a big arm swing. Get that arm back behind you. Let's do sort of like this momentum. Sideways. If you can get to at least parallel to the floor. Good. And then let's see if you can do it behind you. Bending one, bending the other.
Right, right, baby. Shakira. Aluma.
Pretty boy.
Good. Nice. Yeah. And then let's swim back strong.
Colombia. You feel me?
Pretty boy.
Alright, and then again, some vigorous march. We're gonna go down into squat and then up on your tiptoes if you can. Bend the arms up. And up. Lift those heels. And then, yes, for this bone, as you reach up, down and up, down and up. See how low you can go, and then all the way up. Low if your knees are okay with it. Excellent. One last time. Good. And walk it out. Good. And then we'll lift the toes. So you're tapping with the heel. You might have to bend the standing leg so you can touch the floor. Lift those toes as high up as you can. Good. And then we're gonna go to, let's say, the left high, then left heel up, right heel up towards your buttock. Okay, and then again, left heel forward, right heel forward, lift, lift, left, right, lift it back, lift it back, tap, tap, kick your butt. Good. Now let's do one more. Heel, heel, heel up, heel up. Yes. 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 A nice wide stance. Side. And then we're gonna go down. And then back to that nice star pose. Up. So come all the way into that nice power up. Straighten the knee, clear. You can touch the knee or even lower if that's okay for you. for your back. Yeah, nice. Okay, and then we're gonna go either like 1-2, 1-2, or you can go in with a hop in, hop out, hop in, hop out, or 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Okay. If you can do the nice, powerful, dynamic movement. Good. And in. Good. And then walk it out. All right. And then let's just do one more thing before we do our weights. So let's, you can hold on and let's do that swinging of the leg again. So you really try to get it back behind you. You feel the glute work as you kick back. Good. And then switch legs. Swing that leg right. Good. Nice job. Good. Okay, so let's get ready for our 15 exercises. So the first one will be again the butt kicker. So this movement, and then as you do it, you're gonna hold those dumbbells, and then you're gonna do the supination pronation. Okay, so in, out, and see if you can keep the elbows in as much as you can. Okay, so like this. Unless you need to hold on, okay? Okay. One's not muted. Let's see. No, Ilana. Alright, that should be good. Alright. Lift that heel nice and high up and those thumbs in and out. More seconds. Turn it in. All right, and rest. Okay, so the next one will be squat. Come on. Ready? Set, go. Again, hips go back. Punch. Yeah. Come on. Keep going up and down. Down and up. Up, you're looking straight forward. Facilito, porque tengo el corazón y suavecito. 7, 6, 5, 3, good, and then 1. All right, and the next one is a lunge with a lateral raise, so with a elbow bend. So you're lifting like this, right? So right leg, left arm, back. Okay. Like this. So you lift that elbow, bent elbow. Lift that elbow to the side. Step of that opposite foot. Nice big step. It looks like this, right? Keep a 90 degree bend of the elbow. Oh, okay, rest. We're doing twist, and then lift off of the knee. Twist, lift. Twist, right, left, lift the right knee. Left, right, lift the left knee. Right, left, right knee. Left, right. And then you could try to do it faster. That pattern, but feel free to do it slow. One, two, and on the third one, you lift that knee. You're twisting towards the knee. Twist, twist, lift, twist, lift. All right, and rest. Okay, so now we're doing the cactus arm. We're gonna bring those elbows in. Then squeeze the elbows in towards your ribs. Up, forward, open, slowly lower. Halfway up. Close, open, slowly lower down. Cactus, forward, open, lower down. Keep that elbow bent though, and so arms are to the side, right? So my hands are in the same level as the shoulder. All right, and rest. So the next one is gonna be a quad and then lunge, and you can add a push with the opposite arm. Quad, lunge forward. Step back, quad, lunge. Lunge, nice big step. Opposite arm and leg. Quad, punch. Lunge and step. Halfway. Seven seconds. All right, excellent. Good. Rest. Okay, number 7 will be bent over row. So keep the knees bent. Support your back with the core. And then we're doing the row. Elbows bend and you're squeezing them towards each other. So get those elbows up above your back. Una cintura chiquita, mata la cancha, tú estás fuera lo normal. Tú lo bates como la vena de abuela. You want to feel it in the back. It's primarily back exercise. Squeezing the shoulder blade. You lift. 7 seconds. Excellent. Hand that up. Okay, and then we're gonna step back. Opposite arm, leg forward. Straight arm. Or just a tiny bit of a bend at the elbow, but not too much. Step back. Back. Step back. Again, opposite arm lift. Just curl to the floor. There. Piece. You like salsa? Yeah, I'm saucy. Excellent. Okay, and rest. Okay, so next one is we're gonna in a nice wide stance. You're gonna duck under, pop and lift that outer arm. Duck under, pop up on the other side. Duck under. Okay, so you're bending the knees, coming down as if you were climbing under a fence. And pop up. You can always do it without the dumbbells. Lower down, duck under, and pop up. Lower down. Down and up. Good, last one. And now we're just jogging after the break. All right, 5 more seconds rest. And then just stay on the balls of your feet so you can do quick feet. Too much for you, you can always do bigger smash or do the jogging. Fifteen more seconds. You don't need to hold on. We'll do the bicep curl as you lift. Slowly release, okay? Okay, ready, set, go. Slowly release those arms. Don't just let them sort of fall down, okay? So, nice controlled motion. Halfway. Lift as high up as you can. Elbows by your side. 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Next one. Okay, so we're gonna go again in squat. You're gonna open, and then as we extend, try to scissor the arms like we did before. So kind of like a power up in the squat, though. And cross. You can keep those elbows slightly bent. Nine seconds. Excellent, everyone. Good and rest. Okay, so the next one is kicks. If you need to hold on, you could put those down. We're gonna go double kick, and then 1, 2, 3 to switch the legs, double kick. 1, 2, 3. So you could hold those dumbbells or hold on. 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. Double kick. 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 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Double kick. 1, 2, 3. Double kick, two, three. All right, the next one is gonna be, okay, so step back, tricep extension. So extending the arms back, and then you're gonna try to go up with the knee, back. Then we'll change halfway. Same leg. Tricep and bicep curl. And then switch leg. Back, extend the arms. Good, and rest. Okay, and last one will be a bounce in the squat. Ready, set, go. Bounce, straighten the arms and knees. Bounce, open. Bounce, bounce, open. Bounce, bounce, open. Almost done. 20 seconds. Nice and low. From knocking together. And last one, great job. All right, we're done. Get some water. Almost 180 degree turn, right? So you're facing forward and you're gonna try to step back, face back. At least with your head. And then back to center. You could hold onto your chair here. One hand on the chair. So step to look back behind you. Step. Big step out, right? It requires that big opening of the hip, right? To open and then twist in the body. Good. That can be a little bit scary. Step back. Good, nice job. Good. And then let's do a nice side bend, side to side. Getting down towards your knee with your hands. Good. All right. And then let's breathe the hips. So bend your knees slightly. And let's do this movement side to side. First slow. And then you can try faster. Moving the hips to one side and the other, right? And then you just do it more quick. Keep the knees soft. If you lock the knees, you can't really do it. So soft knees or bend knees. Because the knees, as you lift that hip, the knees straighten a little bit in this knee bend. So there's movement in the knees as well. Try it. Give it a try. Good. And then we'll do a circle. Go back, forward, side, all those directions. And reverse. Good. Good. And then we'll try to go step forward, and then you rock back. And then other foot and rock back. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So it's kind of like a rock and rock back. Rock and back. Rock and back. Rock and back. Rock and back. Good. Rock and back. Rock and back. And then as you go forward, you can stick the hip there a little bit. So, rock and back, rock and back, rock and back. So you kind of lead with that hip a little bit. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Good, nice. And then just marching. Let's do the jet hand. So it's that turning, supination, pronation. Good. Good. And then now we're gonna go into a big circle with both arms. So you can bend the knees. You go down. And reverse. Make a big movement. Big movement. Good. And then if it doesn't make you dizzy, we can try to go into a forward fold. So we're sort of drawing with the upper body as well. So up and then down into a forward fold. Bend your knees if it feels better. And then reverse, go the other direction. Excellent, good, perfect. And let's just do one last back bend. So hands on your low back, put elbows back. It opens your shoulders, right? Keep them back. And then see if you can lift the heart and the back bend a little bit. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Don't go too far with the head. So your neck feels okay. Good. And then we're gonna try to come into a little ball. Oh, standing. Good. All right. And then standing up. Maybe let's take one stretch for the back, the downward dog. Into the chair or on the floor. Thanks, it might be easier with the chair. But in any case, you're walking away from the chair and you're moving the hips away from the hands. So lengthening that back, hinging at the hips. Try bending your knees a little. And stay there for a few breaths. Excellent. Okay, so now we're gonna practice stepping. So I'll show you two different versions. Again, the hip mobility, either on all fours. We're gonna first just step forward. So step and then come back to all fours and then do the other side. If this is too much and you feel like you don't have the freedom in the hips, you can be higher up with the chair. As you sit, try to get that pelvis a little bit forward to get that nice stretch. Okay. So either here on all fours and then plant that foot and then plant the other foot or being higher up, or you could even be standing and do nice big, big steps, basically lunges. Okay. Yeah, if you want to stand, then try to keep the upper body as straight up as possible and then do a big step. So bending the front knee, right? And then, yeah, so you feel the stretch in the hip flexors. But on all fours, it's even more, you know, powerful exercise. It's harder, but you'll feel it even more. But, all right, and then we're gonna come back onto all fours, or you'll be standing with your hands on your chair, and we'll do the bird dog. So opposite arm and leg lift, and you're gonna try to hold it for maybe 5 breaths. Okay, so either with the chair or all fours. So let's say right arm, left leg, or the other way, so opposite limbs. Okay, so here, opposite limbs, the one hand on the chair, or you can be even a little higher up, if that's the only version that works for you. One hand here, opposite arm, and leg lift. And so hold each side for a few breaths, keep breathing, and then switch sides. So you're trying to keep the pelvis and the chest level, right? So you're not twisting. You're trying to keep it square to the floor. And then extending. So you have to stabilize through the whole core. Right. And if holding it for a few breaths is too much, you can also move in and out. So out and in. Just try to really lift that leg as high up as possible so you feel it in the glute and the butt muscle. Good. Excellent. All right. Okay. And then to continue strengthening the back body, we all need, if you can, we're going to come down onto the floor, onto your belly. We're going to be working with some cobras, but you could also do it on the wall. So hands on the wall and then bringing the heart towards the wall, but head away. Okay, so that will sort of force you to arch your upper back. Otherwise, coming down to the belly. Your hands will be maybe slightly in front of your shoulders. And then on the inhale, we're gonna try to lift up a little bit off the floor. Yes. And exhale down. Inhale, lift. As you lift, think about moving the shoulder blades down away from your ears. And exhale down. I feel it. You should feel it. I mean, primarily in the upper back. You'll feel it a little bit in the low back. But if you go very high up, then you feel it more in the low back. But we're trying to strengthen the upper back muscles. Good. Yeah, so it's basically the opposite shape of what sometimes Parkinson's makes you look like, right? Like the Parkinson's flexes you over like this. And so we want the opposite. We want to lift the heart, squeeze the shoulder blades back instead of this, right? So this. You could even standing, really press those hands back, open the chest versus this, right? It's kind of like that cat and cow in a way. All right. And then let's roll over onto our back. So you can all. And we're gonna chest. You're seated, just one leg at a time, maybe. Great. Okay. And if you become aware of your breath. Then we'll just do a few windshield wipers. So arms to the side, and then you're moving the knees together side to side. So you're deciding how far you want to go towards the floor with the knees. Yeah, Nalina, you could do a twist. We could do a seated twist. So as you're sitting, you can just hold a twist if that's okay for your back. But only if you're, that's only if you're if you're not lying down. Some people don't want to go down to the floor. So if you're on the floor, then we're gonna set up for Shavasana soon. So maybe let's just do one lift into a bridge pose. So arms by your side and knees bent, feet planted, and you're lifting your hips up, stretching the front of the body. Feel the knees lengthening away from you. So you might feel a stretch in the quadricep muscles, the thigh muscles. Breathe. Good, and then slowly lower, and then sit up for Shavasana. So, either lying flat, or maybe putting a pillow under your knees, or legs up on a chair. And then become aware of your spine. And just notice the spine and the muscles around the spine relaxing, being supported by the floor. Relax your fingers. Relax your shoulders. And relax your belly. your low back. Maybe see if you can connect to your pelvic floor, so the muscles, the bottom of the pelvis. And then relaxing your thighs. Your knees. Your calves. Your ankles. And your feet. And then relax your face. And relax your whole body. Just embracing the body just as it is right now in this moment. And holding it with some gentleness and care. Taking a deep breath in and starting to move your fingers and toes. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side. And come up to sitting. Good job, everyone. So let's close the class at our little intention setting. Feel free to join. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. May I have fun. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead, as a reminder of the power of your thoughts. Hands to your lips, as a reminder of the power of your words. And hands to your heart, as a reminder of the power of your actions. Great job, everyone. All right, have a great day. And again, I mentioned it at the beginning, but if you can, PD Active is doing in her their annual drive. So if you can donate, please donate. I'll send a link with the video, or you can go to pdactive.org. All right, thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. See you
Thank
next
you,
week.
Becca. Thank
Thank
you.
you.